This is Dreamhouse Biodigesters.
The next time you construct a biodigester, construct it this way to get a longer lasting use of the particular biodigester. This is a standard family size biodigester that was constructed for a house. It was an add-on digester in the sense that it was only for the use of the visitor's toilet, which happens to be in a different location of the facility. The idea was that this digester needs its own soakaway. It needs its own soakpit. So for a 3 or 4 bedroom house with 5 toilets, the digesters were constructed earlier by us. We had actually constructed 2 digesters, and because it's a ground floor building, like it's a complete ground floor building, that there's no toilet up and the toilets are far apart from each other, we had to separate them. We did 1 for 2 and then the other one for the other side of the building. But then the homeowner came to finalize the plumbing work. They realized that 1 digester solely will be needed for the visitor's washroom. That's exactly what we came to do. It wasn't difficult getting this job back because we had already shown our worth by doing the other digester, and it had been connected already with a vent pipe the way we wanted it to be done right there on the building. So when it came to constructing the biodigester, all we had to do was use the prefabricated slabs, 5 by 2 dimension, and then we had to just do the digging and then do the wire mesh work by holding them together and then further firming it by using mortar for all the joints. We also laid the leche pipe and then did the inlet pipe. The key part for this digester was having it connected to a traditional soakaway, which was already available in the house. We spoke to the homeowner that this is the best bet. If you want to use this digester for a long time, let's have it connected to a traditional soakaway. So they agreed to it. We use a 3-inch pipe to do the outlet connection to the soakaway, and then we had it done perfectly to match the way we wanted it. Make sure the slope is right when you are doing this so that no water is retained in the digester. Like I have always preached, the key part for you in such a biodigester construction is to ensure that there's no water in the digester. There's no water retained in the digester. Since biodigester is not a holding tank, make sure the water always go out and get a place for it. The key tip and technique for a longer lasting use of a biodigester is not to do a traditional soakaway pit for the digester, but do get a soakaway done and have the water sent there. In the worst case scenario, leave a clean out at the top. If it's not working, have a pump, take the water out from the soakaway. Otherwise, the soakaway will work well for a biodigester because you always have access to the water in the digester. That's exactly what we did right here in this digester. The next time you are constructing a biodigester, ensure that you have a better option for the wastewater management. So here is it. We seal the biodigester airtight. You don't need any vent on the digester. The vents must always go on the building, like we've always preached, and seal it. Do all the metal work and ensure that there's no hole left on the biodigester top so that when people step on it, they hear some noise and some stuff that are not good for the biodigester. This is how the biodigester was done for this house. For better biodigester construction tips and tricks and techniques, watch more videos like the following one on the channel that shows you how to construct a biodigester and construct it properly.